name of our town is Drover's Corners, New Hampshire. It's just across the line from Massachusetts. Latitude is 42 degrees, 40 minutes. Longitude is 70 degrees, 37 minutes. Running right through the middle of the town is Main Street. Cutting across Main Street on the left is the railroad tracks. Beyond the railroad tracks is Polish Town. You know, foreign folks who come here to work in the mills, a couple of Canuck families and the Catholic Church. You can see the steeple of the Congregational Church. The Presbyterian is just across the street. The Methodist and the Unitarian are upper block. The Baptist Church is down in the hollow, by the river. Next to the post office is the town hall. Jails in the basement. Brian once made a speech right from those very steps. It's a nice town, know what I mean? Nobody very wonderful ever come out of it, so far as we know. The earliest dates on the tombstones up there in the cemetery say 1670. They're Grovers and Cartwrights and Gibbses and Herseys. Same names as you find around here now. First, we'll show you a day in our town. Not as it is today in the year 1940, but as it used to be in the year 1901. All right, operator, let's start. Yes, sir, that's the way our town looked back in the year 1901. Along Main Street is a row of stores with kitchen posts and horse blocks in front of them. The first automobile is going to come along in about 5 years. The date is June 7th, 1901. It's just before dawn. Yeah, just about. The sky is already beginning to show some streaks of light in it over there in the east, back of our mountain. The morning star gets wonderful bright the moment before it has to go. The only lights on in the town are in a cottage over in Polish Town where a mother's just giving birth to twins, and down in the depot where Shorty Hawkins is just getting ready to flag the 5:45 for Boston. There she is now. Of course, naturally, out in the country all around, there have been lights on for some time, what with milking and so on, but town folks sleep late. Here comes Joe Cole delivering the morning papers. So, another day has begun. Here comes Doc Gibbs from that baby case I was telling you about. And this is Doc Gibbs' house. His neighbor is Editor Webb. There's Mrs. Gibbs coming downstairs to get breakfast. Later on, about 1910, she's going out to visit her daughter Rebecca in Canton, Ohio. Mrs. Gibbs is going to die there. Pneumonia. But she's going to be brought back here, and she's going to be buried in the cemetery right here in our town with a whole mess of Gibbses and Percys. In our town, we like to know the facts about everybody. And there's Mrs. Webb coming downstairs to get her breakfast, too. Mrs. Webb was a Grover before she married Editor Webb. Yeah.
Children, children, time to get up. George, Rebecca, Emily, time to get up. Wally, 7 o'clock.
Hello, Missy.